In this video, I'm gonna show you how to test the compression of your Mazda RX-8 with a regular compression tester. All of the mentioned items and websites will be linked in the description, so make sure you check them out. And if you're new to this channel and like RX-8 videos, then consider subscribing. A big thanks goes to all the people who helped make this video as accurate as possible. Testing the compression on a rotary engine with a piston compression tester is not as accurate as it is with a rotary compression tester, but it can get pretty close. The tools you're gonna need are a normal piston compression tester kit, really thin tweezers, a ratchet with a 21mm deep socket, a 40cm ratchet extension, a cross wrench, and a jack with jack stands. Park your car on a level surface and secure your front and rear tires for moving forward or backward. Put your car in first gear if it's more prone to move back, or in reverse if it's more prone to move forward. If it's automatic, then leave it in park. And finally, pull up your handbrake. Release the lug nuts on the left driver's side wheel. Jack up the car until the wheel starts spinning and then put it on a jack stand. Remove the lug nuts and take out the wheel. Put the rubber cover on the side so you can see your spark plugs. Here we can see our trailing and leading spark plugs, and today we will be testing our leading. Next, start your car and let it fully warm up to its operating temperature. When it's nice and warm, you can shut it down. Now it's time to remove the crank angle sensor. The fastest way to do it is to spray it with some contact cleaner and wiggle it out with some bent nose pliers. Alternatively, you can also pull out the fuel pump relay and fuse, which are these two here. Put a 21mm socket on the long extension and attach it to the ratchet. Make sure that the head of the extension can move around, otherwise you won't be able to remove your spark plug. If it doesn't, you can attach a swivel joint. Remove the two boots on the leading spark plugs. Release your spark plugs with your ratchet and take them out. Take out the long tube and pressure gauge from the box. Compare the thread on your tube to the one on your spark plug and make sure it's the same shape and size. Plug the tube in your gauge, secure it in place, and make sure that the valve is inside so we can measure the peak compression. Screw it in the spark plug hole of the front rotor and tighten it with your hand. Leave your gauge hanging and set up a device that records at 60 frames per second. Put the car in neutral or park for automatics, press down the gas pedal all the way and crank the engine for 5 seconds and not less. The peak compression of our front rotor is 110 psi. Remove the tube and repeat the process on the other spark plug hole of the rear rotor. And here we have 115 psi. Now it's time to remove the Schrader valve to measure the pulse. Take your tweezers, grab the valve and start turning the tube to get it out. Once it sticks out, unscrew it with your hand and take it out. The tube should look like this. Screw back the tube in the spark plug hole and repeat the same process as before. So neutral slash park, floor the gas pedal and crank for 5 seconds. Repeat the same on the other spark plug hole of the rear rotor. When done, take out the tube, screw in the spark plugs, tighten them and put on the boots. Next, plug back the crank angle sensor and start the car to see if everything is okay. If it's all good, we can move on to the next step. Open a movie editing program. I'll link some free ones in the description. I use Adobe Premiere, which also offers a free trial. Insert the two pulse test videos and cut them so that they are exactly 5 seconds long, starting from the first pulse. To rotate the video, click on it on the timeline, then click on the effects button at the top, and in the upper right bar, type transform. Drag the transform effect into the video. Scroll down and change the rotation by 180 degrees. Next, double click on the main picture of the video and enlarge it. Click on the video on your timeline and slow it down to 30%. Now count the pulses in these 5 seconds. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. until the end of the clip. In my case, I have 27 pulses. Now slow it down to 10% so you can see the needle moving clearly. One pulse is one face of the rotor, so you want to look at 3 consecutive pulses. There should be a repetitive pattern of 3 numbers throughout the whole clip. write down the numbers of these three consecutive pulses. In my case, I have a steady 90 psi across all three faces. Now repeat the same process for the clip of the rear rotor. When done, open my Excel compression test calculator. Firstly, we're gonna write the pulses in the 5-second clips. So I had 27 in the front and also 27 in the back. Next, insert the three consecutive readings. I got three times a steady 90 psi in the front and a peak psi reading of 110 psi. Now choose the highest psi reading of your three consecutive pulses. Mine is 90 since all three are the same. Here we can see that the difference between peak and pulse is 20 psi. And that difference added to our pulse reading will give us the real psi. Repeat the same for the rear rotor. Okay, with all the numbers filled out, it's time to normalize our readings by clicking on the Normalize Readings Here button. Here we're gonna write our three real PSI readings, so 110 three times. Next, insert your cranking speed. Mine was 324 RPM. Insert the altitude of the place where the test was made. And lastly, select the 13B Renesis engine and click Normalize Readings. Change the units into bar and these are your compression results. Repeat the same for the rear rotor and write the results in the Excel sheet. We can see that I have a steady 6.6 bar all around, which is very good. If the compression between the three faces varies in an extreme way, you should not drive the car anymore, as this can badly damage your engine bearings and will make a rebuild impossible. On the bottom left, we can see the compression chart, and I fall into the category of OK, which means my engine still works fine, everything is fine with it, but it produces less power. But if I plan on driving it and keeping it for a long time, I should prepare for a future rebuild. If you have less than 5 bar, it's a good idea to rebuild your engine before it fails catastrophically. To get a final 100% accurate reading, you must perform the test with a rotary compression tester. And as always, all the items and links will be in the description. So if you like this video, give it a big thumbs up and hit the subscribe button so you won't miss out on new RX-8 videos.